innovation, it sounds like adventure, like new beginnings, like successful startups. And I at once think about places like Berlin, Tel Aviv, and of course the Silicon Valley. But there's one place that has to be on this list, and that is Singapore. And next to me is Dr. Ulrich Küster, Chief Innovation Officer at Evonik, and you are a regular guest in Singapore. And the research centers there got quite impressive names like Biopolis and Fusionopolis, and that sounds like straight off a sci-fi novel. So is that really the vibe you've got there? Do you have the feeling like walking through the future?
I don't know whether you walk through the future, but definitely Singapore is creating the future there. And they are doing that by attracting the right talents, by bringing the right people together, the partners together, and thereby they provide all the ground for fantastic innovations.
And what impressed you the most as being highly innovative?
First of all, of course, when you look to the city, it's you have a fantastic architecture like Marina Bay, you have the Hive at the Nanjing Technological University. But there is, of course, much more inside. And inside, there are the people, you bring the right talents there, and you provide basically the atmosphere to really innovate there.
From your point of view, what are the three most important factors for the success of Singapore?
The most important one is definitely the talents, the right brains, the right diversity that you need as people who really carry out later on the innovations. The second one is to bring the right partners together. To really develop this kind of innovation ecosystem, you need the universities, you need the institutes, you need, of course, also the industry and the startups in this context. And thirdly, it's the room, it's the space, it's the culture that you need to create in order to really achieve fantastic innovations.
So that sounds quite logic. Could we take these three factors and say, take a free space in Bochum, for example, and say, well, let's create the Singapore of the Ruhr area?
I have some doubts there. You would need really long-term investment into that to make it a more attractive place, first of all. But basically, you would need these three ingredients for that successful setup.
Innovation comes with friction, with creative freedom and having the ability to network. But yet in Singapore, you've got a very strictly controlled system. So how does that fit together?
I think it fits quite well because Singapore, the state of Singapore, has a foresight team that looks 10, 20 years into the future, and then it directs it on some focused topics into the future with this kind of funding and attracting the right talent that fits to those topics. And for that, you need clearly and guidance.
To push a country in the direction of performance and leadership, as Singapore did in quite a short amount of time, you have to push the people a good bit too. So is there a flip side to the rise of Singapore?
I don't want to call it a flip side, but it's clearly a tighter control. And the control is something that, of course, some people don't like so much. But when you put so much investment into your future, you want to control it and you want to make sure that it leads to something successful.
So let's get back to Germany and your daily work. You've got quite the ambivalence there because you've got excellent researchers who need their creative freedom, but you've also got the obligation to be successful, of course. So how do you balance that at Evonik?
I think we do that in three major areas. First of all, we set very ambitious targets for the people. Then we allow the freedom on how to tackle those problems of the future. And thirdly, we do that on a long-term investment path, and that is really something which you need as ingredients.